Okay, welcome. I'm going to teach you Lady Gaga's applause. Woo! All right, so I'm going to break the song down into five different parts. We're going to have an intro, we're going to have a verse, we're going to have a pre-chorus, a chorus, and then the cool little piano part towards the end of the song that breaks the song down really nicely in the official audio. I hope you know what I'm talking about on that part, because if not, then this is really awkward. So let's jump into it. Before we do that, let me tell you what key we're playing in. We're playing in the key of B flat for this song. So if you look at my blue application up here, those are all the notes that we are allowed to hit. So basically, what that is saying, hey, you're trying to play this song. So make sure you understand which notes you're allowed to hit. That way, you're a more consistent piano player. So if you take notice, I skipped this white note, so I skipped B and E. Okay, so you're not gonna hit those. So remember, this is C right here. So two black notes to the left, C. So you're not allowed to hit B or E in this song. Okay, they're not gonna sound very nice. Instead, we're gonna hit their flats or the black notes right above them. Okay, so if you notice, those are the first three valid notes in this song. The fourth one is right here. Fifth one. Okay, so look at that blue application. Those are all the white notes you're allowed to hit. And like I said, which white notes are we not hitting? B and E. So let's also go through the chords very quickly of the song. What's nice about this song is the chords repeat. The first chord is a G minor. Okay, so you have your G note, B flat, and a D. G minor, F chord, F, A, C, to an E flat, which is E flat, G, and B flat. Then you're gonna come back up to the F and go back up to the G. Okay, so now that we know what key we're playing in, we know what chords we're playing, let's go ahead and learn the intro. I'll play it for you so you know how it sounds. Okay, so the left hand's gonna do this. Okay, so you have a G and a B flat. Then you're gonna rock down to this chord. Yeah, I said rock, like rock and roll. You're gonna rock down to this chord, F and A. Then you're gonna go to E flat and G, and then back up and back up. So it's just gonna kinda do this here. And then you hit this one again and move back up. So back and forth. Okay, if you'd like, an easier way to play this in the left hand is just a single note. So you can go G, F, E. E, F, G. You see that? So if you'd prefer that over this, then play just single notes. Notice that I'm giving them rhythm. That's gonna really make the song come to life. So if you can, play it like this. Okay, so give it some rhythm. I'm going to show you what the right hand is doing. The right hand is doing this. Okay, so what's happening here is you have a D and a G, and that's going to pair up with this one. Okay, see the left hand pairing? Okay, so now watch the right hand. This top note, all it's going to do is open up, and the bottom note's going to stay right where it's at. When you hit this chord in the right hand, you're going to go to that chord in the left hand. So. Okay, now watch my right hand, my thumb, you guessed it, it's gonna stay right where it's at, and I'm gonna open up to that right there. So the movement in the right hand is that, that, and that right there. Okay? And to pair it up with the left hand, you'd go like this. Here, so here. Okay, and then you're gonna go. That's on the way down. You see that? So that switches up in the right hand. So you hear in the right hand, so you go dum, dum, dum. And then you can go. Okay, so slowly, one more time. Okay, now a suggestion. If you cannot hold this bottom note, just forget about it. Okay, so this is a simple way. So if you want to just do the left hand with the single notes and the right hand with the single notes, the right hand would be like this. Okay, and this is how it would sound. Now it would sound like this with the harder way, so it would sound like this. Okay, so you see how much fuller that sounds? So it's up to you. If you have small hands, probably go for the easier way, which is the single notes. And if you have big hands, if you're a grown-up person like me, and maybe have some experience at the piano, try the harder way with those intervals. They sound much better that way. If not, fun the other way as well. So let's move on to the chorus. I'm sorry, the verse. To understand the patterns that help me quickly learn and cover songs here on YouTube, visit my site, improvpianotips.com/products. There, you will find well-thought-out online tutorials that will help you unlock the simple secrets of chord piano. Before you purchase a tutorial, you'll see a demo video link that will roadmap what the lesson covers before you purchase the video. Wouldn't it be nice to listen to a song once or twice, musically understand what's going on, and teach yourself that song in one sitting? That's exactly what I do, and you can too, once you understand the simple secrets of chord piano. Now let's get back to the lesson. So the verse is going to do this. Your left hand is just going to hit the chords I showed you. So coming out of the intro. And then you go again. That's what I'm going to show you. That is the verse. So the left hand, just like the chords I showed you in the intro. Okay, you see that rhythm right there? So try and play with me on that. Let's try it right now. Oh, now I'm messing up. This is awkward. Here we go. One more time. Wow, I can't get it. Let me play it without the snapping. With me. Okay, so that's a rhythm in the right hand. In the left hand. The right hand does this. So together with the left hand, it'd be something like this. Okay, so slowly one more time on the right hand. You start on G, F, D, C. So you have those four. And I'm gonna have your three finger come over. Okay, so this is, in piano, when you run out of fingers, notice I'm done. I can't use any more of my fingers on my thumb here. So instead of picking up your hand and moving it, what you do in piano is you usually do a cross over or cross under. In this case, we're gonna do the cross over. So you see my three fingers coming over. And you're gonna hit that B flat right there. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see that? And see how it then sets you up? What happens? Three finger comes over, let go of your thumb, bring it over here, and you see how you move your hand? Okay, that's how you move quickly on the piano, that run. So basically what you're doing is you're figuring out a way to move your hand down the piano, and the way that you do that is by crossing over. So you learned something new today, right? So cross over right there. And so one more time. And you're gonna go here in the right hand. 1, 2. So and here. You see that? So try it slowly. Thank you. you'll do that four times. The intro is twice, so you have... That's once, and you'll do it three more times. Sorry, here's once. That's once, then do it again. Yeah, Lady Gaga went jazzy. So you'll do that four times. I've showed you the intro and the verse. Let's move to the pre-chorus, which is the part that she says she lives for the applause, the catchiest part of the song. The left hand is going to do this. Okay, the chords are going to change. And if you notice what happened here, you were playing this, right, for a G minor, the first chord? Well, all I'm doing for this pre-chorus part, which is the applause part, where she's singing applause, you take this D note and you move it down here. So you're gonna have this chord. Same chord, different placement on the piano, that's all it is. So you have G minor, then you have your F, and E flat. Okay, and so coming out of the verse, I'll play it slowly. Okay, so you see what happened? Coming out of the verse on the last time, you're gonna go here, coming up, and your right hand, instead of moving up like that, you're actually just gonna stay on this G. Okay, see that? And then you're gonna jump into this part. Okay, so I'll go slowly through that. This is I live for the applause, 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 that part. So. Oh, I messed up. Sorry. Let's try it again. Oh, goodness. I keep messing up. I'm so sorry. Let me try it again. Okay, so the right hand. Left hand is doing the same thing over and over those chords. Okay, a little bit quicker together. This part changes up, so you're gonna go right hand, jump all the way up to this G here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, you see that? Okay, that's just the same thing that I showed you in the verse, right? So it's these four. Okay, so. Okay, so all together, this pre-chorus part goes like this. Okay, when you come out of that part, then it goes into the cool transi part. And for the transi part, you're coming from here, right? What you're gonna do is you're just gonna play the chords. So let me show you how I play these chords to sound really nice and full. If you can, hit a root and fifth, so it's going to be a G, D, and then add the octave of G in your left hand. Right hand hits an octave of B flat. If you cannot hit the octave, just take away the thumb. Do this. And if you cannot hit the octave in the left hand, take away the thumb. See that? So you can do this. Now, if you can do the octaves in both hands, it should sound like this. Okay, you see that? that. That's all you're going to do for the chorus. You'll do that four times, and then it breaks into the middle section, which is a cool little piano part. And the piano part actually is going to come back up here, so it's going to go like this. Okay, this is exactly the same chords that I showed you. So like I said, they just repeat over and over. So here's the middle section. Now watch this. What you do after hitting this chord is the left hand moves to here to hit these two notes. The right hand stays right where it's at. So, you see that? So you're going to go here, here, and here. Now watch my left hand. It's going to move. My right hand stays where it's at. And you hit that chord right there. Okay, so that's the middle part. One more time. Then you're gonna go into the chorus again and finish the song. Now remember, if this was confusing and you're like, what? I'm not sure how he's piecing this all together, go listen to the song. If you know the song well, then it's gonna be so much easier listening to my tutorial and learning the song. So I hope this was helpful. Leave some comments down in the section below if you have any questions. I'll be glad to reply and clear up any confusion if there is any. Remember, subscribe to my channel if you'd like to hear cool covers and then also tutorials like this one on new popular songs that just dropped on YouTube. So this song just came out today, and here I am doing a tutorial for you. Make sure you subscribe.